Match game 74, production number 0254, take one. Get ready to match the stars. Joey Mitchell. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Eddie Deutsch. Richard Dawson. And Marshall Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you for joining us here today or any day, and we thank you for joining us because we couldn't do it without you. Isn't that funny? How are you? Good. What?
What'd you say? I was talking to Brett.
What'd you say?
Nothing.
Get out! All right, you all ready?
Yeah.
All right, are you ready to greet the players over here?
Oh, no.
Let's say hello to Carlotta Nelson and Susan Warren. Hello, ladies.
Hello.
How are you? Carlotta has won $4,150, and that's a lot of money. And are you happy about that?
Very.
You got plans for the money?
Yes.
What are you going to do with
it? Well, I'd like to decorate my new apartment.
What? Really? She's going to decorate her new apartment, Scully.
Yes, but with whom?
No, we're just taking a trip.
She's got plans for the money. She's not taking a trip, and she's being challenged by Susan Warren. We're in the middle of round one, right? Susan, you've had your question. You scored once, and your question for round one will come up in a moment or so. But first, we got this message of interest, if we ever get to it. This is it. All right, I'll push a button and reveal this question for Carlotta. Ready? Listen carefully. Everybody plays. Confucius say...
Oh, another dialect.
You look forward to my little acting jobs
Great
here.
Great anticipation.
That's because you don't do them every week,
Patty. The fish is saying, life is like...
Just a bowl of cherries.
No, life is not just a bowl of cherries. You listen to what Confucius say. I Confucius, you not Confucius. You confusing Confucius.
By the way, not so much.
Yes. Confucius say, life is like nest of giant bird full of blank. Say life is like nest of giant bird full of brank.
A brank, right.
A brank. Now you understand what Confucius say?
Yeah,
okay. You write something for Confucius. You understand what Confucius say, Carlotta? No? You don't understand it?
Maybe
you want a one-on-one
tall,
one chicken egg drop soup there. What do you want?
Scully tried to
Confucius
steal
say
my
life
answer.
Is like nest of giant bird full of blank. Don't say nothing yet until I say you say. Then when I say you say, you say. You finished, dummies over there?
No, go ahead. Say it again.
Say again? How many times you want Confucius say that? Confucius say, life is like nest of giant bird.
Right. Singular bird, right?
Bird. Full of brank.
Male or female?
Always two bird in one nest.
Not in my life, honey.
Anytime, Charles.
Oh, Charles!
Charles, you're going to make Confucius very unhappy, I think, with that answer. All right, Carlotta. Confucius say life is like nest of giant bird full of...
Giant eggs.
Giant eggs. Tenors. Okay. Yeah. Scully.
I do.
Confused girls say giant eggs. What do you say?
I wanted to match her until I found out how she had planned to spend that money.
So now?
I said that my life is like a giant bird nest full of rotten eggs.
Rotten eggs, giant eggs, there's a match. There's one for you. Okay. All right, Brett.
Well,
I mean, it's really the jolly green rotten.
That's it. Yeah.
You know, I've grown old on this show. And my nest has been a little empty lately. So it's just full of bird doo-doo.
Charles.
Move over, bird doo-dee.
The guano heap seems to be enlarging as we move along here. What say you, sweet, innocent little girl? You don't make Confucius mad.
No, never.
No, what do you say?
No, I just did the singular, bird do.
Oh.
You know, it sounds like a new hit for the Andrews sisters.
Do-da, do-da.
Richard. Now, pull it all together.
I'm
go
sorry,
ahead.
Richard, it's your turn.
Yes, these childish words of doo-doo are just silly. I said droppings.
Oh, dear me. Well, Marcia, it's been an uplifting show so far, right?
So far, it's just been wonderful.
Are you going to drag it down?
No. I'm going to keep the level of good taste we've maintained this whole thing with doo-doo, which is what my mom called it.
Yeah, okay. All right. So, Carlotta, you've scored one match, and that ties the score. It's 1-1 at the end of round one. Round two will be along shortly after this message, so do come back. Okay. Excuse me. We've got round two coming up. 1-1 the score. Susan, would you make a selection?
I'll take B.
What's that?
B.
B is what she wants. Last time you matched Scoey, so Scoey, you do not write. You do not write. You don't have to leave the room. Just don't write because you matched her in the...
Never mind.
All right. You dropped something. Okay. Here we go. Sheila called the Missing Persons Bureau and said, I want to report my husband as a missing person. When last seen, he was trying to blank a gorilla. Sheila called the Missing Persons Bureau and said, I want to report my husband as a missing person. When last seen, he was trying to blank a gorilla.
I'm very glad I'm out of this one.
Yeah, you're lucky. It's a hearty. Susan is thinking about that while you're writing your answers.
I have friends in the audience.
That's nice.
That's debatable.
All right, how we doing?
Not very well.
Okay, everybody ready now. Susan, Sheila called a missing persons bureau and said, I want to report my husband as a missing person. When last seen, he was trying to blank a gorilla. What do you put in that blank?
To kiss a gorilla.
He was trying to kiss a gorilla? Yeah. You like that? Want to tell us the rest of the story? He kissed the gorilla, and the gorilla liked it and grabbed him and ran away with him, and that's why he's missing. Is that it? Okay. Kiss a gorilla, she says. Brett, what do you say?
Well, you know that all gorillas wear fur coats, right?
Yeah, right.
Strip.
The strip a gorilla. That's a good answer. Charles?
So this shouldn't be a total loss for that lovely girl. I put kiss.
Kiss a gorilla. There's an answer, Mary Susan. Okay. How about when last seen he was trying to blank a gorilla?
No, he wasn't. He was trying to dress a gorilla.
Trying to dress a gorilla.
Not easily done.
No.
That's why he was trying to get the fur coat off.
That's right. Richard?
Yeah, Brett has a new fur coat.
She does.
I said, what you have to do for it? She said, just shorten the sleeves a little.
I said, hug a gorilla.
Hug a gorilla.
Al Hugo.
No. No kiss there. Marcia?
Well, gosh and golly. I felt that it had gone past the kissing and hugging stage. And they going to date and perhaps pick out furniture.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, the two of them, huh? Okay, so that was one for you. And now you need one to tie and two to win, Carlotta. The Godfather said.
Another
Italian.
I know you're thrilling.
Oh, God,
won't you be surprised? I read it straight. Yeah. Wouldn't you be surprised?
Yeah.
I ain't
going to
read it straight.
Okay.
Godfather
Life
said.
Was just ball of charred.
No, that's not the Godfather. Oh. Is
I double dog dare you.
Once I do that, he cannot get the accent.
Remember, sir.
Dirty rat.
Good day.
No. Remember, no.
This could be the end of a great career.
No, quiet, everybody. This is a serious show there.
Antipasto.
Remember my motto.
Well, that's the Jolly Green Giant.
Always leave them blank. No, the godmother says, remember my motto. Always leave them blanking. That's what your godfather said.
Do I play?
No, you don't play because...
If you remove your card, they'll tell you. It'll either say don't write or it won't say
anything.
Leave
him alone. I'll run the show.
Oh, fine.
You keep your mouth shut or I'm going to have you taken care of.
Oh, I go crazy when you act like an Italian.
Okay, Carlotta. The godfather said, remember my motto. Always leave them blanking.
Swinging.
Swinging. Uh-oh. You got a lot of holes there from the audience. I don't know what that means. Swinging is their answer. And there's some logic to it, but let's see if it matches. Brett?
Oh, crikey. I said, always leave them dead, which I guess is like swinging if you have...
No. It could be dead, but... It's the modus
always
operandi.
Leave them laughing. I said, always leave them bleeding.
Always leave them bleeding. Apparently, the audience likes the bleeding answer, Carlotta. Now, let's see what this lady has who loves my acting so.
Yes.
She's never going to appear on this show again.
Never. No, I said, always leave them bleeding.
Bleeding. I guess the audience seems to think that is the answer.
I'm too small.
That's right. You need one to tie, Carlotta, and you got two celebrities to go here.
Well, it's the godfather one say, always leave them bleeding. Bleeding.
Okay, you've got to match Marcia to stay in the game, and your answer is swinging, and now we show Marcia's answer.
Well, dying.
Dying. So, Susan Warren is the winner. Congratulations. There's $100 for you, and we'll see how it turns out in a moment or so. Well, Carlotta, you're going to leave here a pretty rich lady. And it's going to be an amount of $4,150. We congratulate you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank all of you.
Enjoyed meeting you. Goodbye, Carlotta. There goes Carlotta.
She was sort of like a regular on the show, wasn't she?
She was a regular on the show. She's been on more than you have, Scully.
Yeah. She's got more rights, too.
Listen, are you ready?
Getting more, too.
Susan Warren here is going to have a go at over $5,000, and this is the way it happens, Susan. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Henry. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, it's $250 for you. And if you match the third, it's $100. Which celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
Richard.
Oh. Oh, Henry. Okay.
Charles.
Charles, what do you say?
King Henry.
King Henry. Okay, you have two now.
That's Brett. The court.
And Brett.
You don't have to explain. We all know who King Henry was. Well, there's only one left, I guess. Do you have anything in mind, honey?
Yeah, I have a date.
The only thing I can think of is that cute Buck Henry.
Buck Henry.
Well, I didn't have to be met with total silence from
you. So you've got Buck Henry, King Henry, and O. Henry. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
I'll say O. Henry.
You'll say O. Henry? Okay. That's the one that Richard gave you. Let's find out if it's up there. And if it is there,
John
where?
Henry.
First.
Very good.
May we see the $100 response? Patrick Henry.
Who in heaven's name is Patrick Henry?
I haven't got time to tell you now. Here come the Lions. Let's press on here. And we're looking for O. Henry.
Nathan
Hale. Here is the $250 response. John Henry. Marvelous song. John Henry was a steel-driving man. All right, looking for O. Henry, third and last chance for Richard Dawson's answer, and let's see if it matches. Here we go with the $500 response. O. Henry it is! Congratulations! Hey!
You're welcome.
Okay. Well, Susan, you got the $500. Now you play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000, and you've got to match one celebrity to collect that amount. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, Richard. Now, you'll face me, Susan. I'll get the $5,000 question.
Very rowdy.
If you would please, sir, write your answer to this. Wise blank. That's W-I-S-E blank. Something's going on up there that doesn't concern us. Now, don't distract Richard. He's trying to think of an answer.
Distracting Richard? I was just writing down what I would say.
Now he's finished. And Susan, we call on you for an answer to match Richard. What do you put in that blank? Wise?
Owl.
Wise owl. The audience says, I don't know. Let's see if you do match Richard. Richard, for $5,000, may we see your response?
I first wrote wise men.
Wise men. And you threw that away, did you?
I did. I should have thrown this away, too, because I didn't know she was coming up with wise owl. I said wise guy.
Wise guy. Good answer.
I'm sorry.
Wise guy is good. Wise men was good. Wise man was good. Wise owl. There are some good possibilities there. Well, listen, Susan, you've got the $600, and you're going to play another game in a moment or so after we do a little business with America. Here you go, America. Now, we're ready to start another game, if you're pulled all together here. And to do that, we're very pleased to present a new lady. Here is Barbara Jenkins. How are you, Barbara? Let's find out a little bit about Barbara Jenkins, shall we?
Well, I'm single and a liberated lady. And I'm originally from Oklahoma. In fact, my dad flew out from Tulsa to see me tonight.
Your dad's here?
Yeah.
How can you be liberated if your dad's here?
Well, he came out to give me a little moral support.
Oh, you know? Good. All right. And you're from Tulsa, Oklahoma?
Mm-hmm, originally.
And you live here now?
Yes. I've lived here for almost 7 years. And I am a flight attendant with the major airlines, and I've been flying for 7.5 years.
Nice to have you with us, Barbara.
Thank you.
Good luck to you.
Good to be here.
Good luck to you. And I'll push a button, and we'll begin. Would you make a selection?
B.
B is what you want, and B is what you get. Here we go.
She's liberated. I was wondering if she, you know, maybe she's taking some prisoners. I'd like to give myself up.
Okay. You are a sly rascal there.
Well, she's certainly better than a kick in the head.
Here we go. During her circus act, Wanda the fire breather breathed in when she should have breathed out. Now she has barbecued blanks. If you understand that, I'm sorry. I had my back to you, Barbara. I'll do it again for you. During her circus act, Wanda the fire breather breathed in when she should have breathed out. Now she has barbecued blanks. Okay?
I mean, I'm finished. Why are you killing some time? I just
want to see what you're doing here. Wrong.
You mean wrong? Who taught you how to roll down the steps?
Only kidding.
He rolled down the steps last week and hurt his ribs. Who taught you that?
Yeah, you did.
And ask her if she's taken any prisoners.
You'll have to ask her yourself. Speak for yourself, John.
All right, I'll just drop her a note.
Now, dear hold liberated. Everything. Get a response from Barbara. During her circus act, Wanda the fire breather breathed in when she should have breathed out. Now she has barbecued blanks.
Tonsils.
Tonsils. Okay. She says, have barbecued tonsils. Scully, what do you say?
Well, I'm sure had Carlotta been here, we'd have matched. I guess it's just another one of those cultural gaps. I said barbecue ribs.
Barbecue ribs. Okay. So much for the soul food. What do you say, Brett?
Well, they all like that stuff.
Oh, it's terrific.
Well, I figured she was a non-smoker.
Yeah?
Now, you know that if I breathed in, it would go, be stuck right here. No, but I thought she didn't smoke, so I thought she had barbecued boozies. Chest.
Really?
What do you think of that?
I don't know. I'm just being quiet and going to pass right on quickly over
I
to Charles. I've
been better off with ribs.
Yes. What do you say, Charles? Tonsils is the answer she's looking for.
I'm sorry. I said lungs.
Lungs. Okay. So far, no barbecued tonsils, I'm sorry to say. What do you say?
Side order of barbecued lungs.
Lungs.
To go.
Yeah. Ribs. I like Scully's answer better than that. At least there's a touch of humor there.
Now we come to the part of the show where we'll have an instant replay. Come here a second.
Yes?
I finished my answer and asked to be taken prisoner by this lady.
As I should speak for yourself.
Huckleberry Dillinger, look at my card. I said.
Wrong.
Now ask her if I can be her prisoner. Consul.
Okay.
You know, you two guys should go to Vegas. They really should.
And take a room.
That's a great idea.
Okay, Marcia, what do you say?
Well, one of my favorite dishes, barbecued feet.
Barbecued feet. I mean, she really took a deep breath now, didn't she? Joe, could she breathe? What a lung capacity she had. All right. Now we put that away, and we'll come to you in a moment or so, but first we've got to come to you, dear friend, and here it is. All right, Gene Rayburn here for Match Game 74, thanking all of our celebrated folk and asking you to join us next time for another session of this dazzlingly witty, marvelous program.
Stay tuned for Travel Tales next over most of the CBS stations.